Okay, here's the deal. We got Riley here who volunteered to help me, Josh who might get it drafted, and me. And we're up against a 3,500 pound mill that we've partially stripped down. What we've got is, we've got a GoPro over here doing a time lapse. We'll see how that turns out. And we've got a newly purchased trailer since, thank you U-Haul, they won't get you rent one to go from point A to point B. You gotta bring it back to the same place. So, we'll see how things progress.
What can I do?
Maybe if one could get on the inside, it wouldn't hit you. If it came loose, it wouldn't hit you.
Where's number 11?
So it's on the trailer. The core, the heaviest part, 2,800 pounds worth, is on the trailer. That's an accomplishment, man. That is an accomplishment. Okay, so the electronics cabinet is here. We got the mill head here. There's the motors and the drive assemblies. We still have to put them in some wood or something to keep from getting busted up. That's the main body of the mill. That's 2,800 pounds in a 3,000 pound trailer. So that's where we stand now. Okay. The only thing left to pack now is the rest of the GoPro equipment. There's the machine. There's the machine. There's the machine. And there's stuff.
All the bits and pieces.
All the bits and pieces. So We're gonna go to the hotel, get a shower, get some sleep, and then we'll head out in the morning. We're tired. That's all I got. Let's see what happens here. Let's see if it's stable. Tight squeeze. How's it handling? Okay. Make a right. And we're on our way.
Well, got the suitcases packed. I woke up about 6. Riley? Not so much.
Okay, it's Saturday the 24th, and Riley's had a good night's rest. We're gonna head out here. We're leaving the hotel. The GPS says we'll get there about 2 p.m. tomorrow? Ah, that's longer than I anticipated.
After 250 feet, bear left, Chesterfield Parkway West.
Well, we got about the first half hour down, 45 minutes, however long we've been driving. How's it handling?
So far, so good.
Cool.
Hardly anything's falling off.
What you doing?
Checking the oil.
How we doing on it?
Looks good. Better, it's fresh oil.
Yeah. Looking pretty good. You got new belts in there and everything.
Yep.
So how old is this spring chicken?
It's an 89.
89. Just getting worn in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Alternator problems. That grinding sound means it's going to fail soon. We got to find an auto place. We got about 15 minutes to find one before they close. Ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. Riley is a mechanical genius. I gotta say that. Okay, alternator broke. See that spot over there where the street lights are? We could have parked there.
Hey!
But no, we're parked over here. But I gotta be nice because he's fixing the car. Oh.
This is nice?
This is nice. This is as nice as I get.
Oh, dear.
Oh, jeez. So, new alternator, new serpentine belt. And what was the damage on it? About 140-ish.
Yeah, something
like that. Yeah. So, added to the cost. Still cheaper than buying an $18,000 CNC mill, so I'm not going to cry too much. And I get cool footage for my YouTube video, right? Woo! Day four of our two-day trip. Yeah.
Really,
yeah.
That explains a lot.
I thought it was Saturday, but it's not. It's Sunday. The days just kind of roll by. So, you know, Riley was going to drive up on Wednesday, load the thing on Thursday, and we drive back and get there late Thursday night. Didn't quite work out. But we're almost there now. We're 3 hours. Yeah, so, woo! Well, the monster's here. Hey, Riley, how's it going?
Well, let's inventory our fingers.
Yeah, we're all good. So I had to pull some stuff out of the garage because this thing's not exactly tiny. So, we're kind of figuring that we move this table back and we're going to put it here to where the motor is sitting up here just out of range of the garage door. And that way the electronics can go over here and in theory we can still get to this table and get around it to use all the other tools. So right now it's a mess and we're going to get ready to move out the big monster.
Bottom here. Try and keep the pipe in here.
Okay, this is the top of the mill. And this is what it looks like in there. Big hollow cavity. And we're going to attach the top piece on there. And hopefully this is something we only have to do once. So I'm going to let Riley hold the camera there. And what happens is this piece has to go in here. And the way it does it is it tilts in like this. And then once it's in like this, it's hard to do while holding light.
Hammer light.
You have to get it closer. Get it. Yeah, there you go. So this piece goes down in here. It only goes one way, right? There. See, it sits up in here like this. And then what happens is when we get the other piece on here, it'll lock in like this, and that'll form the pivot. And it only goes a certain way, so it's got to go like this, and then the front head goes this way. So now that this keyway is in place, we'll put the head on. And that's not easy. That being the head. You know you got a big machine when you can sit on it like this and put it together. We're just about there, actually. We're doing pretty good. We got the head back on. We got the motor back on. I got to put the Z drive. That's not that bad. And it'll top out right about here. We're just going to make it on the ceiling space. I thought we'd have to cut a hole in the ceiling, but... Woo! I'd kiss it, but it's crazy. But it works. I mean, it works.
What you doing, Riley?
Oh, nothing.
Getting ready to do just a little bit of wiring. Put it back together again like Humpty Dumpty, right?
Ah, we should be so lucky.
We're dirty.